Flexbox, or flexible box layout, is a CSS layout model that makes aligning items in HTML many times easier. And if you ask me, this is the most important concept of CSS that you should learn about. And in this video, we will cover exactly that. So let's get right into it. So I am at my VS Code and I have already written some HTML and some styles. So here I have one div with the class name of box container and which is being shown over here. So inside this div, I will add few boxes. So I will use one shortcut. I will write dot box, which will give me the class name, and then hashtag box hyphen dollar, which will give me the unique IDs. And then for the values, I will write inside curly braces box dollar. And I want four boxes. So if I will multiply by four, and here I get the four boxes accordingly. And the boxes are also being reflected in the box container. Now to understand Flexbox, first of all, we have to imagine two axes, one vertical and one horizontal in the box container. So I've already made those two axes. So I will simply uncomment the green axis and the blue axis. And we get the axis. Now I will go to my style.css file and I will ignore all my base styles and I will come down to the box container, which is a wrapper for all the boxes. So first of all, I would like to give some styles to the individual boxes. So I will write box. And let's first give one border of 2 pixel solid red, and let's give a background color of light coral. Let's also give a height of, let's say, 75 pixel, and also one width of 75 pixel, and we get it. And let's also align the text at the center, and let's also give one margin of 5 pixel. Yeah, so we get our boxes. Now to use Flexbox in the wrapper of all the boxes, that is the box container, here I will write display of flex. And we see some changes. And the boxes are aligned horizontally. And that is because when we are writing display of flex, we get another property, and that is flex detection, which is row by default. Now we can also change it to column. And now the boxes are aligned in the vertical direction. Now we can also change it to row reverse. And now it will consider the row is starting at the right hand side. And we can also make it to column reverse, and the boxes will start from the bottom. So this is giving us a flexibility. Now we will change the flex direction back to row, and we will take a look at few more properties. So there is another property, and that is called justify content, and the default value is flex start. We can also change it to flex end. And other than this, there are some important properties, and that is called space around, between, and evenly. So space around will do is it will give some spaces in between, and the spaces are at the edges. It is some space, and in between the space will be twice of that. And apart from that, we have space between, and the spaces at the edge will become zero, and the remaining space will be distributed evenly in between. And lastly, we have space evenly, where in the edges as well as in between, it will have even spaces. Now this is for the horizontal alignment. Now we also have another property, and that is called align items. This is align items, not center. And what this align items will do is, again, it will have few more things, and that is, first of all, it will have something called baseline. And what this baseline will do is it will align all the text of the boxes at one line. So let's say for box 2, we have to use by ID. So for box 2, let me increase the space, let me increase the font size to, let's say, 1.5 rem, and as you can see, all the text is being aligned. So let's remove it, we don't use it much. So apart from align items, it will also have the similar properties, and that is it will, by default, it will be flex start. We can also make it flex end, and we can also make it center, and it will be centered in the vertical direction. Now we can also make justify content center, and all the boxes will be centered in the horizontal direction. And now there is one thing to note, and this is, all of this is happening because flex direction is row. If flex direction becomes column, then the properties of justify content and align items will be reversed. So let's remove it once, and now let's also do justify content center, and as you can see, it is centered in the vertical direction. If this was row, it would be centered in the horizontal direction. So that is the basis of Flexbox. This is something you need to understand, that this flex direction is the driver of Flexbox, and the rest of the things will follow along. Now, apart from this, there is also another property, and that is called flex wrap, and we can make it wrap. So the default value is no wrap. Otherwise, we can make it wrap. So what this will do? So, and to understand that, we have to make few more boxes. So what I'll do is I'll create few more boxes in the same process dot box, and then we will use some ID and we will use some values of, let's say, from, and let's give $1 over here, and let's give values up to, let's make it 16. And it's not working for some reason. Let's make it 16. Yeah, so we get 16 boxes, and let's remove the first four. And as you can see, there is a very big issue over here, and what is happening we don't know. So what we can simply do is we can change this flex wrap no wrap to wrap, and as you can see, the boxes are aligned very well. And let's remove the justify content center for a better idea. And as you can see, after the box 5, it is sending the box 6 in the next row because there is no space for box 6. And this is what flex wrap is allowing us to do. And when we are doing wrap, it is also giving us another property, and that is called align content. And there is no need to confuse this between this align items or justify content. This align content is only active whenever the flex wrap is wrapped. And what this align content will do is it will allow us to model these boxes whenever there is flex wrap called wrap. So let's see how align items works. So let's start with flex start. So as you can see, the gap in between is gone and it is starting at the starting position. We can also make it flex end, and this boxes is aligning at the end position. So let's remove this number 16 box. It is causing some issue. Let's remove last two boxes. Let's make it only up to 14. And yeah, so as you can see, flex start is at the start, flex end is at this end, and we can also do other things with it. So for example, we can do center, and all the boxes are at the center. And apart from this, if we do justify content center, these boxes will be at the center. So whenever there is a wrap with justify content, we have to use align content and not align items. Yeah, so that is the thing with justify content. And apart from that, in flexbox there is also another property, and that is called gap, so which will increase the gap between all the boxes. So let's let me remove the margin from this. And as you can see, all the boxes are stacked, but we can give some gap over here. So let's give the gap of 10 pixel, and we can see that it is acting quite like a margin, but there is a slight difference. And to see that, I have to comment out few lines. So here I will only keep the display of flex, and let me just comment out these four lines. So now the difference between gap and margin is that there will be some gap at the top corner when we have a margin, but for the gap will only be between the boxes. So let me reintroduce the margin over here. That's a margin of 5 pixel, and let me comment out the gap. So as you can see, there is a small gap in the corners which is coming from this margin, but when we have gap, this small gap at the corners will be gone. So that is the basic difference between gap and margin. So now we have styled our boxes using our align content and justify content and align items, which is basically aligning all the 14 boxes. But right now we will see how we can align individual boxes. And to do that, I will simply remove all these four lines. So let's just comment it out, and I will remove 11 boxes. I'll keep only the first three. And so we have our three boxes. Let me give the margin and remove, just comment out the gap, and I will identify each box with their ID. So let me identify the box 3. And so now, how can we align each individual box? So I can use something called align self. And again, it will have flex start, which is at the top, at the correct position. Flex end will be at the bottom, and I can also make it center. And I can also change the position of this box by some other means. So let's change this thing to flex direction to column, and let's give no align self right now. So now we have this thing. Now when we do flex start, align self, flex start, we have box 3 here. When we make it flex end, it will go accordingly, and when we make it center, it will be positioned accordingly. So that is how this align self works. And other than this thing, there is also few other ways we can change some of the styles. So let's comment out this flex direction, and the next thing we will see is something called flex grow. So let's say in the box 3, I do something called flex grow of 1. So as you can see, the box 3 will be taking the whole space of the remaining space. So now what happens if I take my box 2 and here give flex grow of 2. So as you can see, the box 2 is taking more space than the box 3. So what is happening is this flex grow 2 and 1, this is proportionally taking the remaining spaces. So for box 1, let me give it flex grow of 3. So the amount of space these boxes are taking will be proportional of the flex grow. So now let me remove the box 1 and 2. And now let me show you that there is something else called order and few other things also. So what we can do is let me just save. We have the box 3. So now the box 3 is positioned at the third position. Now every box has an order of 0. And so every box has an order of 0. But if we make it minus 1, what will happen is the box 3 will be positioned first. But this is something that is not recommended because this will be messing up with their original positions. So for box 2, if I make it order of minus 2, as you can see, box 2 will be coming first. But let's not do this thing. And apart from this, there are also a few more things like flex shrink. And then we have flex basis and things like this. And all of this, flex grow, flex shrink and flex basis, like all of these things can be compiled into one property called flex, which will have three arguments. First one will be the flex grow, second one will be the flex shrink, and the third one will be the flex basis. So flex shrink is how the boxes are allowing us to shrink. So some of the boxes will shrink more, some will not shrink so much. But these are not some properties we use too much. So you can definitely check it out. But we will close the video here only. That's the basics of Flexbox. Thanks for watching. Bye-bye.